We are back. It is Current Mood, Season 3. When I say I have missed you, I mean that I have missed you. I finished a year of touring, and every Sunday night, I knew that there should have been a Current Mood and there couldn't be. Tried to do it even during a show in the set break a few times. And in the intervening months, I've really grown to miss this show and love this show. And I hope you guys are well. It's been a while. Anybody who did come out to see any of the shows, thank you very, very much. It's just been a great year. Great year. And we'd like to say, see what's going on down now in the comments. Come to Chile. Of course, again, travel agents. Just nothing but travel agents. Where is Shawn? Shawn is here. Don't worry about it. He didn't leave. What's up, General Like USA? I missed you too. I missed you too. I was in Europe. That was great. Put on a lot of weight in Europe, which is great because people go, oh, he went and ate great food in Europe. Cliff bars. I ate Cliff bars. They don't have the right picture on the cover of a Cliff bar. They got a guy climbing a rock. It should be a guy playing an iPhone game in his bed using his sternum as a candy bowl. Because that's what I used Cliff bars for. Okay. You like the fluffy stuffed animals behind me? Thank you very much. I hope you guys had a great Friday and Saturday. I hope I didn't actually contribute to anybody banging themselves up too much knowing we'd be here at the end of the weekend, but I wouldn't give myself that much credit. Long shot, but come to St. John's, Newfoundland. Newfoundland. Portugal. All right. What is weekend? That's what someone wrote. I have a show to do. You can't break my brain with an existential question like that. I have things that I've got to do. Okay, well then, let's get on with the show. Hey, here's a fun thing that happened this week. The Sonic the Hedgehog trailer, they did a new trailer because people were upset with the way Sonic looked the first time. Let me show you what that looked like. This was Sonic the first time, and you can't see it here in the room, but it's the first time that I've ever seen a CGI character that I'm sure had bad breath. He has upper teeth and lower teeth. So they fixed it, and they came up with a new trailer. They've actually fixed Sonic, and the trailer came out, and people are pretty happy with it. I myself, underwhelmed. There's just a few things. It doesn't look right to me. Take a look here. This is the new Sonic the Hedgehog trailer.
Sonic, a little ball of super energy in an extremely handsome package. On my planet, people were always after my powers, so I came to yours. It gets a little lonely, but that's okay. I am living my best life on Earth. Ow! Let the flip Sonic!
Anyway.
On my planet, people were always...
But go out and see Sonic. My friend Ben Schwartz is the voice of Sonic. They've kept him, changed everything else. That was just a gag I came up with yesterday on the treadmill. It's time for tonight's Can I Talk to You Over Here for a Minute? Powerade bottles. Your caps are on too damn tight. I'm going to attempt to open a Powerade bottle, and I'm not going to joke about it. I'm going to try to open it. I got it. That one wasn't that hard. But imagine having that 3 a.m. just woke up strength where your wrist is like a 9-year-old boy's. You're never getting this thing open without spraining it. Did you hear that? It sounded like... Tastes like red. Powerade bottles. Caps are on way too tight. I thought that bit killed. Tonight's sponsor, How Long Are You in Town? Are you thinking of canceling plans with someone who just visited town and you want to try to mitigate their disappointment? Well, use How Long Are You in Town. It makes them think you have intentions of rescheduling, even though you absolutely don't. How long are you in town? Available literally everywhere. What else is going on? Cut my finger on a do lid, is what someone said, which might be the coolest thing anyone's ever said. Went to open a Mountain Dew, sliced my finger on the lid. You see, I was in the middle of some extreme sports. I was parched. Energy levels were dipping. Took off my moto gloves. Turned off the engine. Opened up a Mountain Dew. Slit my finger on the lid. But it poured some Mountain Dew on it and healed up immediately. It's strange, but it is true. Where's Shawn? That's another comment. I guess everybody just really loving my comedy. this show costs nothing for you. Just remember. All right, listen. I know what you like. I know why you're here. You're here for this stuff. Brazil pictures of text. We should just bring him on. Would you be ready, Shawn, if I read your intro right now?
Yeah, I was really liking watching you, but sure.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I was racing through. It's my first time back in a while.
I really like it.
You know, played to thousands and thousands of people at a time, but something about sitting here in front of 28,300 is freaking me out. Folks, my guest tonight is an immensely talented singer-songwriter who spent most of the year at the top of the charts and is currently in the middle of a sold-out world tour. You can hear him most recently on Taylor Swift's Lover remix. I have it right here. I printed it off Spotify. That's why they don't make records anymore. You can't buy them in a store. This is how big music is today. Printed off Spotify. Also available, the vinyl. Please welcome my dear friend, the one and only Mr. Shawn Mendes.
Thank you. Hey.
Everybody, look, it's Shawn Mendes.
I really love watching you do this.
Thank you.
Because I don't know, my ego told me that I was supposed to be right off the top and that you weren't going to have an intro, and then you started, and I was like, oh yeah, I should just watch him for a sec.
Yeah, we would take a second and let me establish the not funny for a minute.
Well, I was so impressed with this. You put the Sonic trailer on.
I come with bits.
Do I get to do that? Or is that only something that Current Mood gets to do and John Mayer? Can I do that also?
What?
Can everybody do that?
It's like, available to everybody.
Cool.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
What are you going to share when you get home?
I have so many things now that I knew I had to know this.
What do you think the last picture in your camera roll is right now? What do you think the most recent picture in your camera roll is?
It's like definitely just like a photo of my face.
Is
like
it?
How I look. 100%.
Oh, you use it as a compliment.
Yeah, yeah, like 3 seconds ago.
Yeah. You could have just asked me.
Yeah.
You look great.
Thank you. So do you.
Before we begin, let's just...
Can I say?
Go.
I'm really so happy to be here.
Thank you. I'm happy you're here.
It feels so nice.
This is a place where an artist is asking questions of another artist. Two guys who are constantly in defense of what might be asked, what might be coming their way, and you can just sit here and just enjoy the fact that nothing uncomfortable is coming your way.
Absolutely not.
Although I have to ask you one question.
I'm sure something uncomfortable is going
to happen. I have to ask you one question. We have to get to the elephant in the room.
Do it.
Can you open this Powerade bottle?
Absolutely I can.
Up!
Oh yeah, whoa. I was not expecting to be that tight.
How tight is it?
Very, extremely tight.
It's extremely tight.
Way too tight. I don't like this. And I'm not going to drink it.
All right.
I'm sorry.
There you go.
Probably tastes like purple.
Hey, Powerade, loosen up.
Yeah.
Relax. Loosen the fuck up.
Chill out.
You're supposed to give me power, not take it from me.
But you know what? I can't tell what's more nerve-wracking. Is it the 30,000 people here, or is it the 10 in front of us?
It's a mix of the both. I would say that 10 people you know is about the same as 30,000 people you don't.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah. Would you be okay if would you rather have 30,000 people you don't know don't like you, or the 10 random people from your personal life not like you?
Wow. 30,000. I think... I mean, I'd love you guys, but I think I'd be devastated if 10 people.
If 10 people. But you could go work the 10 people and apologize one
time. You could. I mean, you could also do that to 30,000.
The 30,000 people who are all... No, I'll tell you why. The 30,000 people who happen to be together to watch you do something that makes them mad will never assemble again for you, so you can apologize
right.
to them.
You could never get 30,000 people.
So you screw up. And 30,000 people go their separate way, and they all hate you. And you can't put it back in the bag.
What country, like, are they here? 30,000 people here?
Just for me, they're here. Oh, the people who don't like me, that split up in 2009, they're still around. They're hard to find. I still catch them every once in a while. I go, about that. We hug in the club, and it's over. Mm. One person
at a time. You don't go to the club anymore. I've never seen you at the club.
The racquetball club.
Yeah.
The racquetball club. Grow up.
I had to beg him. Just come get a drink with me one night.
We look like two prisoners who just broke
out. We did.
We just broke out. Hey, guys, welcome to Fugitive Talk.
I had a blue shirt on. Saw him put a blue shirt on.
He had it on first, and I put it on.
It's true.
I got to tell you something. People go all the time like, oh, you know, it's so, you kind of sort of taking Shawn under your wing. And I want people to know something, that in this very room, about a year and a half ago, I showed you a video, and I said, I don't want to put this thing out. And you said, you better put this thing out. Tell people what the name of the video was that I showed you and I said I wasn't going to put out, that you yourself said you have to put it out.
Well, it was the music video, it's New Light. But what was the exact title you had?
It's called New Light Premium Content.
Premium Content.
Yeah.
And he was panicking.
And I said, it's too stupid. I think the song is really sweet. And you said, dude, you have to put it out.
Oh, it was immediately the most genius thing I've seen all year.
He's the reason I put it out.
Yeah. Well, no, I mean...
You are the reason I put out New Life.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks for telling me that. Well, yeah, they love it. They love it.
We both have great hair.
Oh, yeah.
Do you get...
Shawn is John Jr.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yep. He's like a... He's like a me if I got to watch myself play a video game first and then see where the pitfalls were
totally.
And then play it.
Or no, you got to ask yourself how not to do that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You
on on a daily basis.
Yeah, my Wikipedia is your inner voice.
Yes, exactly. I still make decisions for myself, but mostly not.
Yeah, yeah. No, you just do what I did for most of the time and flip it.
Mm-hmm.
You should live lavishly. Are you coming to India? Have you been to India?
I've never been. Have you? You've been to India?
I have not been to India.
I've not either. We're coming.
Actually.
See you soon.
together, you and I. I was going to say that together, you and I could do a stadium, but it's pretty much like a lot of the same people. So they'd be like, I'm here for John and Shawn. He'd be like, oh, we were kind of looking for two times the people.
Right. So you have this amazing ability to do this thing with your eyebrow. That's just great for a talk show host because I can't do that.
Oh, well, I have to make sure that it doesn't come off douchey. You know how sometimes you think you're smiling in a picture when you're not?
Yeah.
Well, I think that sometimes I don't look like a douchebag.
What does that look like?
When I do.
Wait, no, what does it look like when you're smiling in a picture
like,
but you're not?
I get kind of rock eyebrow. Oh, this is me thinking I'm smiling, okay? I'm not going to look.
Yeah.
Inside my head, it feels like there's a person on either end of my lip pulling really tight. Like, I feel like we are
this
full
is mine. This
flora.
Is mine.
That's yours?
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, it's like, hold on, I can't do it. It's like a...
Wow. Look at these two guys. Wow. What about a male reboot of Thelma and Louise?
Oh, yeah. I love... This is so... It just aesthetically is so nice. Like, this is all...
It's aesthetically real.
Sitting between our shoulders like that.
I want it to be like basement-y.
Does everybody know how tall of a person John is?
You're taller than me.
I don't think that's true.
How tall are you?
Six.
You're like six. Ugh. Six.
The first time I met John, I went into the studio, and the first thing I thought...
They want to see you, not me.
The first thing I thought about him was, you walk in, and I'm like, hey, like, nice to meet you. And his paws of hands...
Yes.
They're huge. And I have big hands, but you should put them next to mine for comparison.
You have big pinball
You have paws. You're like a bear. Look at those things.
Well, but I had it
up
close.
Yeah, yeah, I was doing that.
We have to be on the same plane.
All right, I guess they're not.
All right, do that.
Look at that thumb. Just so you know, everybody, the thumb over the thing move, it's hard. John can only do it because he has... This is weird. Yeah,
I can play like
the... Not normal
third,
human.
Yes, it is weird. Let's do the friend handshake one more time. Friends. Oh, that's interesting. Now it's symmetrical. Now it's
This is a friend hug.
Look at that. Oh, my God. It's a hand hug.
Hand hug, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, on Sunday night, well, look at this hand hug. This is our new... Ready? Go like this again. Hand hug. Oh. From now on, whenever I see Shawn Mendes, no matter if we're an award show, I don't know, I would be there. Wherever we are, we're going to stop the room cold when we see each other. Let's do it one more time. Hello, friend.
John.
Good to see you. Hand hugs. Me and my friends giving hand hugs. Hand hugs. Okay, hand hugs. I have a couple questions for you.
This is so much fun, actually. I'm really enjoying myself. I want you to know that.
Oh, it's palpable.
I really want you to know how much fun this is.
Thank you.
I love talk shows. I think they're amazing, but they're so scary.
Yeah, they are. And they get a very small window of opportunity to get anything done. I find like playing music on talk shows, you can only not do badly. The two choices are you didn't do badly or you did badly.
Yeah, exactly.
But there's no way to win.
You cannot. It's hard. It's hard to like...
Were you going to sing right there? Not many people. It sounded like it was a musical for a minute. You were like, it's really hard. Not many people really understand the soul of a man in a green room.
It's true.
Three and a half minutes.
When you... John invited me on the show. I came 2 hours early.
Yes, you did.
They went to his fridge and they ate his food.
You're the sweetest person.
You are the sweetie. You gave me the food.
No, you're the sweetest person. Thanks. You said, do you have an apple? You texted me.
Or a banana.
Or a banana. I said, Shawn, I have both. What do you
mean? Some people don't have an apple or banana, and that is the easiest thing to eat from somebody without feeling guilty.
Oh, you could eat anything. I have food prep.
You go to someone's house and you see an apple on the counter, and you've no problem taking that apple.
The only thing you're not allowed to eat at someone else's house is their yogurt.
Absolutely.
You can't just eat another person's yogurt.
Because there's only 2 to 3 in the fridge.
And they know it, and it's allotted for certain times. A person's yogurt stash...
There was a time yogurt was really so incredible.
You think we're past peak yogurt?
Oh, my God.
What do you think the golden era of yogurt was, Shawn? Shawn, I love that every fan of yours is watching right now, waiting for some morsel of gossip to share with you. Here we are. What do you think the golden era of yogurt was?
It was like an act. Do you have Activia in America? Well, you do, okay. I'm super...
Do you have prostate cancer?
Yeah, okay. So, Activia. There was an Activia with granola in it. And berries. It was just coming pre-mixed like that.
Is an Activia for older folks?
I think it's for people with stomach issues.
Do you have stomach issues?
No. I just love Activia.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, wonderful.
Are you wearing diapers as well? Just cuz?
Yeah.
Oh, they're soft.
Yeah.
Yeah. One time in college, my friends and I put adult diapers
Look,
on.
Look who we have.
Oh!
Mila says she loves you. My gut says she doesn't pick up, but I don't know.
Boom, boom. We have a game to get to and everything. This is so much
fun. I've never done this before.
You want? Did you see the hand hug?
No.
Watch this hand hug.
Wait.
Wow. Good one, guys.
Hey,
one.
You look really pretty. Where are you?
Doing a music video. Can you do it with me?
Yeah.
Aw.
I mean, you can do it too, but I think she's asking me.
Well, that's not fair. I'm so there. You guys are having so much fun and talking about yogurt and stuff.
Hand hugs.
No.
Shawn is talking about the golden era of yogurt, and we found out that he enjoys Activia just for the taste.
Activia is, I completely agree with that. Who knows if it makes you poop more, but it's great.
Yeah, definitely.
I just thought
that's what it's for. It was fiber. It was the fiber.
It's for fiber. I think that's bullshit. I do.
Yeah.
Do you get enough fiber now?
Definitely not.
Well, that is information that I feel like I shouldn't share, but I think so.
No, you shouldn't. But I just want you to know, I would love to see Pop Sugar make a headline about your fiber intake.
Oh, yeah.
That's happening now.
It's happening right now.
What's the video you're shooting?
For my song Living Proof.
Living Proof, and that's coming on the record Romance very soon.
Oh, thank you for that promo, John.
Yes,
nice heard it. It's
phenomenal.
So you're shooting
the
video.
Yeah, he was here 2 hours ago.
I was there, and but can I say why I was what was going on?
Yeah.
I was there, mm-hmm. Right? It was all fine. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna go see she's doing it. Then next thing I know, she's doing a dance scene with this guy, and he takes his shirt off. And he's super jacked, like shredded, like. And he's
baby,
like,
but not jacked like you.
No. Not jacked like you, baby.
He's doing his stretches and stuff.
He was doing.
What
stretches.
Is the music? What's happening?
Oh, that's a theme song for a game we're about to play.
Anyway,
actually, you could be here for the game if you'd like to play the game.
Do you have time?
Actually, it's really cool if you will you sit here and play the game with us. Do you have 3 minutes?
She literally asked, that's the, I really have to go because she has
to. Do you have 3 minutes?
I kind of have to go, huh?
No, you gotta go. You gotta go.
Look. Oh my God.
Oh my God, the crew.
I'm doing it. How long is the game?
You can just hang for a while and leave in the middle of it.
Yeah, you can leave whenever you want.
Great.
Okay, I'm going to read off a fact about somebody, and you and Shawn have to tell me if it's about Shawn Mendes, Camila Cabello, Camila Mendes from Riverdale, or Cabela's Outdoor Superstore.
You know Cabela's Outdoor Superstore for sure.
No.
Okay. So the game is called Camila Mendes, Mendes Cabello, Cabello Cabela's Mendes, and the theme song is.
Camila Mendes, Mendes Cabello, Cabello Mendes.
Wow. Pretty fantastic.
So, the first order of business. Is it Shawn Mendes, Camila Cabello, Camila Mendes, or Cabela's Outdoors? We didn't need that. We didn't need it.
Cabela's Outdoor.
Here we go. Born in Cohima, Cuba. Shawn, this one's for you.
Cabela's Outdoor was not. Can't be born. It's a store, man.
It was Camila Cabello. She was born in Cohima, Cuba.
Oh, no.
I can't believe you thought your girlfriend was an outdoor superstar.
You weren't supposed to be on, right? You're supposed to be busy doing a music video.
I know.
Once right, left okay, their wait. Underwear at my recording studio.
Wait, say that again?
Once left their underwear at my recording studio.
Done. Camila Mendes?
Not you.
That's inappropriate.
Not me. Shawn, do you know who it was?
Do you know who it was?
I mean, it can't be a store can't leave their underwear. Actually, it can because it's a postman. So I guess
yes,
I
that's
say
true.
The hardware store. I'll say the
it was me,
store.
But I have a question. Yeah.
It was Shawn Mendes who left his underwear.
Did I leave my... I did. It wasn't the underwear I was wearing.
That.
Nope.
It was the new underwear.
But I know how to get a clickbait going on. I'll tell you the story later on. Their first acting job was a commercial for IKEA.
Okay, well...
Camila Mendes, the only one that has an
actor. That's definitely Camila Mendes.
That is Camila Mendes. That's correct.
Yeah.
This person doesn't know how to ride a bicycle. Who doesn't know how to ride a bicycle?
Me. That's me.
Cool. With that, we'll send you back. We'll send you back to work. Thank you
very
much.
All right, guys.
Thanks.
All right, guys. How do I get up?
Camila Mendes, Mendes Cabello, Cabello Mendes.
Let's do a couple more.
Unplanned.
5 foot two. Is 5 foot 2.
Is 5 foot 2.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how tall Camila is, but if she, I guess she's 5 foot 2.
Both Camilas.
Oh.
Both Camilas are 5 foot. Also, both Camilas won a Teen Choice Award in 2017.
Wow.
Is married to Ryan Gosling. Huh. Is married to Ryan Gosling.
Well, there's only Cabela's.
Nope. Keep going.
Camila Mendes. Is,
nope.
Is it not?
Nope.
I don't see you.
Mendes.
It's Ava Mendes.
Wait, did you know they were? Did you?
It's a trick question,
Shawn. I really
Shawn.
Genuinely did not know they were married. So sorry.
Well, you didn't get the invite.
Yeah. Did you?
Nope.
Okay.
Nope. I made my own invite. Mm-hmm. I printed my own and sent it to myself from the mailbox, et cetera.
And denied it.
And I denied it. Yeah. But I chose the chicken.
Yeah.
I chose the chicken. You ever choose the chicken?
I don't know. Actually, I've never been to a wedding.
You never been to a wedding?
I've been to one when I was maybe 7.
Bombshell.
Sucks.
You've never been to a wedding?
I know.
Wow. I'll tell you what. I had never gone to a wedding when I was your age. I don't think I went to a wedding until I was
28. I can't wait to start going to weddings. They seem like the most possible fun you could have.
They're a real blast.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta tell you something. There's two different types of weddings. There's when you're table one, and there's when you're not table
right,
one.
Right, right.
I go to the table one.
Right, right.
I go to the weddings where I get the shout out.
Right.
You're going to learn this. You go to the weddings where the new bride is teary-eyed, and she's like, and I just want to thank Shawn, who came all the way. They single you out. They go, he is on tour. He came all the way from Paris for this. And you're like, table one.
I just realized I was at a wedding, and I'm pretty sure that happened one-to-one wedding. But anyway.
You did go to one wedding?
I did go to one wedding. That something like that. Something along those lines happened.
Yeah. Everyone else is like, this guy. We all came here, too. I just want to thank Shawn in particular. We know you're on tour. You're so...
Do barely
you think
friends.
People know how busy we actually aren't?
Yeah. Like, do you think people
think you're busy. Oh. They think we're really, really busy. But they don't know how often we do nothing all day in a hotel room. Oh. They think we're busy because we're not at home.
Well, they think we're busy because we're not tweeting something or right. Instagramming something. But in all that time that there's not something happening on social media, we're doing nothing.
You're doing nothing.
We're just looking at you.
Yes. We're looking at what you have to say about this, America.
Yeah.
And so. Beyond. Well, that was a fun game. Can I play the song one more time?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so. You're so proud. Camila Mendes, Mendes Cabello,
Cabello, Cabello, Mendes. I gotta tell you something. That song is stuck in my head for the last 36 hours, and it's a nightmare. And I only hope to bring you deeper into my nightmare with me. I hope that all you watch and go to work tomorrow, and as you're doing your thing, you're going, bum 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 bum. And everyone's like, what is that? You're like, I don't remember.
Ridiculousness is asking to play a different game.
I do have one more game. Do you want to play another game?
Well, I'll do anything. This is your show.
Yeah.
I'm just like,
you're luck, by the way, can I point something out?
Yeah.
You're absolutely loving this. Meaning, like,
you can tell, like,
you're a pig in shit right now because you've never had this kind of connection or freedom.
No,
take
it.
Chill with it.
I've been on live like twice.
Yeah, no, but think about, like, you can do whatever you want.
Yeah.
That number will go down next to live.
What are you guys even doing out there right now? What's everyone doing? Where are you watching it, and who are you watching it with?
There's a lot of fireside watching right
nice.
Now in the colder states.
Oh, yeah, even in Canada.
People waiting all
day.
You're
cold out there.
A lot of hungover people just took their last bad dump an hour ago.
still
you know,
talking about the
bad,
things.
You know, day of bad dumps when you're hungover. Mm. And you can tell when, like that's probably it. and then you feel like your first good hour of the entire day.
Have you had many mornings where you wake up and your friends are explaining to you what you did, or were you always so hyper aware?
Good question.
So scared.
My problem was that I never got drunk in a way that took my faculties away. So I was the drunk guy coordinating stuff still.
Right.
Thanks
right.
very much, sir. That, you know, talking to bouncers, like,
yeah, yeah.
I really appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Totally,
like,
too.
I'm still a war general.
Yeah,
when
yeah,
I'm drunk.
Yeah, me too.
And so I wake up the next morning and people don't believe that I'm as hungover
right.
as I was.
Yeah.
And, but there were a couple nights in my life I was blackout and I don't, that's frightening.
Yeah.
It's frightening.
That's a lot of people's Saturdays.
Yeah, it's right. It's a lot of people's Wednesdays.
Wednesdays.
Thankfully, I can't keep up with it. And I had my last drink 3 years ago. My last drink 3 years ago. So,
why are you telling me that?
You know, it's a rock and roll. Rock and roll. Okay, so I do want to play one game with you.
Okay.
One more game.
Yeah, yeah.
We could just do a few of these and then we can hang out.
All right.
So I think your voice is so beautiful that I think you can sing.
So beautiful. Thank you.
I think you can sing basically anything. And to prove that, I have a couple of unsavory lines written on blue cards. If you would pick up the guitar and with your beautiful voice, sing some of these lines.
Do you want to play it? Or do you want me to
play it? I'll play it, and then you take the card. Let me find one that's really good.
You know,
okay,
it's really cool.
Try this one.
Okay.
Would you mind if I smoke the rest of your cigar, baby?
Beautiful. Let's do it again.
Would you mind if I smoke the rest of your cigar, baby?
Would you mind?
It's beautiful.
Would you mind?
Would you mind if I smoke the rest of your cigar? How about this one?
Nikki grew up listening to your music, by the way.
Well,
so did I, Nikki, and now look where I am. Hey.
You want to try this one?
This is your favorite. Oh, yeah, we have Zoom ability.
Okay, ready?
I can't believe you can Zoom live.
I went out in the rain and now my slacks are moist. My slacks are so moist. My khaki slacks are so moist, yeah. I went out in the rain and now my slacks are so moist.
My slacks are so moist.
Wait, honestly, I genuinely don't know what slacks are.
Really?
Yeah, I'm genuinely.
Slacks are the worst imaginable name for pants.
No.
I went out in the... You actually did make it sound great.
And now my slacks are so moist.
Yeah, my slacks are so moist. For everybody yelling collab for Shawn and John, they're like, yeah, but I didn't mean this. No, everyone,
this is what you get.
It's not the collab you deserve.
No.
But it's the collab you need. What? Can I... maybe just one more, right?
Yeah, let's do one more.
Let's do one more.
See, look, I'm not alone. Sahana doesn't know what slacks are.
Slacks? Does everyone here know what slacks are?
Yes.
Let's do this one, okay? Take that one.
Yeah.
Let's figure it out.
All right, let's do it.
Your cat should beef just fine with a couple of pieces of salami as a treat.
Tell me.
Because your cats should be just fine. With a couple pieces of salami as a treat.
Salami as a treat.
Cats have a little salami.
Wait, what is this?
This is because cats can have little salami.
Yeah.
Cats can have little salami. Cats can have little salami.
Little salami.
Oh, cats can have little salami. Oh, salami. Salami sings good. Oh, salami.
Salami sounds like a beautiful name for a girl.
Oh, no.
Salami.
There's one more.
I have a daughter. I'm naming her Salami.
You're going to have to take that up with Camille.
I guess I will.
This one, I will do. I drive my car fast, real fast, in residential neighborhoods.
The problem with this is me not trying to sing a John Mayer song when I do this.
Oh, you know, yeah. we're all doing each other. Even a relatively ineffectual punch can knock somebody over.
The problem is these are actually like the sentences are kind of confusing. So
oh yeah,
like,
no, it's
they're not
to be
simple.
Confusing.
Yeah, sentences.
There was one more that I really liked.
Even a
relatively ineffectual punch can knock somebody over.
Yeah, only you can do that. Really.
Cause them to bang their head and sustain a fatal injury. Oh, I had another one, but it had the word orgy in it, and I'm not going to get to you.
There's kids here.
I know you better than that.
There's kids here.
Wow.
I have kids, though.
Can I play the song one more time?
Oh, yeah.
Camilla Comendez, Comendez Cabello, Cabello Comendez, Mendez.
Wow. Do you want me to take that?
Yeah. I don't want to make you my roadie.
Oh, yeah. I got you.
The action's a little high, too, if you don't
I
mind.
Know,
right. Well... This is the part of the show where we admit we finished the show.
We were not done already.
37 minutes in. This is kind of it.
You said somewhere around 40 to 43.
Yeah, this is about where attention starts starts dripping away from people. That's where that number starts.
We've only gone up. We were at 31 2 minutes ago. Now we're at 35,000. They deserve
a little more conversation.
What do they deserve? What do they deserve?
Let me see. I got a couple more questions. If you want to answer some questions.
I always want to answer questions.
Okay, ready for this? Shawn, you have sold millions of albums. You've had hundreds of millions, if not billions, of streams. You're on a sold-out world tour. Shawn Mendes finds something to complain about. Don't back down. Answer this question.
A genuine answer of something to complain about.
You are in no position to complain, and yet you must. Find something. That's what I'm talking about. Life ain't perfect. Everyone knows life isn't perfect.
Okay, you know what it is? If I'm at dinner with my sister, it's really mainly my sister.
Right. You're saying you don't want to have dinner with your sister.
That is like, please don't come up.
People it's bothering you.
Yeah.
Well, people approaching you when you're having dinner.
Yeah, with my sister.
Right.
That gets me because she never asked for it.
You have found a very strategic answer to this question.
You thought it wouldn't.
The blood is thicker than water thing right there. It's great. It's great. Oh, God. That's a good one.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure it's true. It's true. Maggie Rogers was on here one time and turned it into like a more social answer. It was like a societal answer. And I was like, damn you.
Was it good? Was it really good?
It was the smoothest way out from that question I'd ever seen. Yeah, people when you're with your family. Now imagine it's your baby. Imagine you have like a 6-month-old. God, that's got to be crazy.
I could not imagine
being that. A dad. I love the way I got you that last ugh in there. Not about that. It's like when you're texting someone and you throw a text in there and they agree to it. Last text.
Right. Okay. Thanks.
You've spent a lot of time in hotel rooms. And though I don't think you've ever done this exactly.
She says, guys, finish already so Shawn can take me on a date.
Oh!
And then she says, ugh.
Oh, she misses you.
Mm. Oh, tell them I haven't slept for 5 days and keep waking him up, LMAO. She can't sleep. It's insane.
Why do I feel like every time you talk about you and Camilla, you're also talking about the plot of A Star Is Born?
Oh, my God. I feel like
I went and saw her at the set today.
Yeah.
She was doing these dance moves. I had my old ruddy leather jacket on. And I just finished penning a song.
Had three Wilco. Three whiskeys.
Why do people who play drug addicts in movies always cough? They always have a cough.
It's enticing to have to be rough and to have something going on in your throat.
And they always open their pill bottle towards the camera. That's gonna be a gift. I'll do it for you. Okay, so you spent a lot of time in hotel rooms. You haven't done this, I'm sure, but what's the closest you've come to trashing a hotel room? What's the one thing you've done? You went, that didn't feel right, but I can be a rock star about it.
I hate that it's like, I mean, it sounds like, I sometimes really sound like I'm lying.
Mm-hmm.
This is not a lie.
No, I don't.
I genuinely don't know, but probably just like throwing the water bottle I just drank at the garbage and missing.
Right, and the walking out.
And then leaving. You know, I mean, sometimes I feel bad if I get my hair cut in the bathroom and don't.
I'm with you on that. Yeah. I think hair is almost like a bodily fluid.
Yeah, it's gross.
Yeah, I do think hair should be considered a bodily fluid.
Oh, yeah.
No, I really do. If you threw a bag of your hair at somebody, that to me would be.
But also, even worse than like just hair in a bag is hair on the bathroom floor.
Yeah, no,
a little
damp.
You might as well just
open some pills
that
on
that. That is what that is. It's the same exact thing.
Okay, let me help you with this. Have you ever used all of the towels in a hotel room?
Absolutely.
All right, that's more than the...
Yeah, oh, that's more.
I think using all the towels is more than...
Okay, so honestly, I admire people who do this, who hang their towels up in hotel rooms to dry and use again later.
That's adorable. I do use my towels as all-purpose absorbent things. Yeah. You ever use a towel as a napkin?
Yes. Yeah. That's messed up.
That's what we do. A towel is a nap. I mean, it's a catch-all. Literally, it's a catch-all. The phrase catch-all was started because it was a towel that you used for everything.
Have you ever been using the towel and then thinking about that? Because that means other people use it for that, too.
Oh, there's a powerful bleach involved in each of these.
That's what you hope.
Oh, no, there's a powerful... I'm the really reason that people don't touch the remote control.
Oh, yes.
I'm not scared. No, I'm the one who knocks. You ever get in a new hotel room and you're like, I'm going to fuck this place.
Do you ever have the lady just walk in to refill the refrigerator or and not?
The Otter Bar?
Yeah.
No.
I've had that.
But I have a very strict thing about people not coming into the room.
Yeah, I don't.
I also don't mess with the Otter. Do you go into the minibar? Do you do minibars?
No. But like, I think that they always just come in no matter what. Especially if you're a musician. Like, that shit's empty.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you got to just put the DND on the door.
Yeah, I know.
And they still come in?
I know, I just don't put that on it.
Oh, come on. You got to put the Do Not Disturb on it. It would be such like Shawn Mendes, which is like, if you need me, though.
I'm here at all times.
I'm here at all times. Like, I mean, I'll be asleep, but my phone is on.
Yeah.
So if you need
me. Just come and slightly shake me.
That's incredible. That's amazing. No, I'm going to get you a Do Not Disturb sign.
Thank you.
But if you had a Do Not Disturb sign, it would be the nicest Do Not Disturb sign. It would say,
please don't
no
disturb,
offense.
But if you really need me, it's okay. Come in anyway.
Yeah. No offense. Don't take this the wrong way. I've had a really long day. I'd like a little bit of sleep. So if you don't mind, would love to see you again in a few hours.
But
do not disturb.
If you do need me.
If you need me, I'm just a phone call away. You know my room number. You have my key.
You're fine.
Are you a good waker-upper?
Great. Are
I
you?
Am too.
Yeah, phenomenal. Yeah, I'm sleeping and I go, all
I'll
right,
go right
here
up.
We go. What's the day?
I'll start talking immediately and be fine. I can do a business deal.
Me too.
I can wake up and straight do a business
deal. Yeah.
I'd be better off if I did.
Yeah. Well.
I'm
genuinely sad this is over, but I get the feeling that we're bantering for them.
No, this is fun. This is going to go on Current Mood after hours.
Okay, great.
Yeah, this is overtime.
Okay, great.
It's going to be on the Current Mood streaming service.
Anybody
have questions for Shawn before we? I think I'd die happy to see you guys perform comfortably.
Oh, that's really sweet.
I just remember that time at the market. Shawn, I need to see you in concert. Well,
you had a chance.
You just missed it. You just missed it. I was so available to you.
It was extremely
10
so
of these
long,
last 12 months. Just missed it.
It's just a lot of hellos.
How do I break this to you? Camila Mendes, Mendes Cabello, Cabello Mendes. Mendes. All right.
Wonderful.
What do you say we give one more hand hug? I play this jam out, and then we do sort of like the last bit talking like they can't hear us, but we'll fake talk over it, like it's the music going out. So I want to thank everybody, especially Shawn Mendes, for coming. What a sweet, cool, smart, great guy. Record again, Love a Remix. Well, it's not featuring Taylor Swift, it's Taylor Swift
featuring
you. And so go check it out.
Go check it out.
Also want to say, I like the song. I like the song very much.
Thank you. Did you like my verse?
Love your verse.
My songwriting.
Love your verse. And I'm only going to say one thing, and I know it's going to go far and wide throughout the media, but I'm a guy, I'm a musician. I can talk about a song. Love the song. I really like the song. I get a little chuckle because she says, we can keep the Christmas lights up till January. And I go, you're insane. Everyone keeps their Christmas lights up till January. And I go, can you really? Like, because normally I take my Christmas lights down on December 29th. But anyway.
But you like the song?
I love the song. I love the song. And I love your work on it. Were you in the same room or was it sort of hard drive?
No, I was in Australia.
You did yours from somewhere else?
Yeah.
Got it. So we won't see the video where you're Beauty and the Beasting it.
No, I really wish. Yeah. Beauty and the Beasting it?
Where like, it's, you set the mic to Omni and you come on and it's like, Beauty
and
the
That's never actually, they've never used that vocal. Just
no,
so you know.
Nor has anyone used the phrase Beauty and the Beasting.
Except for you.
We can keep the Christmas lights up till January. And then about January 5th, we'll take the lights down. And we'll put them in a box and we'll label that box Christmas lights. Yeah, we'll put them in the attic. Till next December. Well, that's a crazy love, I'll tell you. All love.
All love.
We had to have a little time.
We love you.
Yes. Young love is
crazy. We're getting more.
Shawn, I'm taking you
the
air.
We're getting more people.
I'll tell you what you want to do. You want to go until something hurts.
You guys.
We're leaving before anything hurts. Okay? It's all love to everybody who had a long week. And has another long week coming. Hang in there.
Have another one. I'm coming back every Sunday.
Every Sunday. He's part of it. He's
you ask for it, you get what you want.
We love you. Take care. Be good to yourselves. Hang in there. We'll see you soon. Shawn and I are going to do the news thing where we play the theme, and then we have a discussion where you can't hear it, and then we're going to go out. Thank you so much. Thank you, Shawn Mendes.
Thank you
to the studio audience.
the right song.
That's not the right song.